morning and welcome. I'm Lynette Andrig and I'll be your liturgist this morning. And we'd like to thank Anna and Pat for our beautiful music this morning to start our service. Let's pray our opening prayer in unison. When you look in the mirror, who do you see? Do you see Jesus reflecting back? Paul reminds the church in 1 Corinthians 13:8. That in the past, we could only see through a veil-covered mirror. But through the birth, life, death, and the resurrection of Jesus Christ, the veil was torn to the temple of our eyes. And so we can rejoice in seeing clearly. Therefore, he writes in 2 Corinthians 3:18, we can see the glory of God as though reflected in a mirror. As we begin worship, we praise you, God, for allowing us to choose to be transformed into the same image as Christ, from one degree of glory to another. May we also not only see Christ in our mirrors, but may others see Christ reflected in us. We pray this through the Son, who reflects the Father. Amen. Remain standing as we sing Open Our Eyes, number 2086 in the Faith We Sing hymnal. Spirit into this space and into our lives to help us with our baptismal promises, to resist all evil and wickedness, and put our whole trust in your grace, acknowledging our shortcomings in doing both. May the Holy Spirit fill us, move us, shake us, inspire us, and transform us to better reflect Christ in our lives, relationships, and practices. Through this experience of worship, come, Holy Spirit, come. Remain standing as we sing The Summons, number 2130 in the Faith We Sing hymnal.
Oh, invite you to be seated as we come to the time to share those things that are on our hearts this day, joys and concerns. And there are communication cards in your pews that if you have a prayer to be voiced during the worship service, to write that down. If you have a prayer that you would just like to be prayed over, just fold that in half. And as we sing through the CARES chorus to set that attitude for prayer and the mood for prayer, Lynette and I will be through to the congregation to collect any prayer concerns. So. Have not heard or seen, the twins are here. And so, Scott, would you, go ahead. Here we go. So these were some pictures that Kate posted out on Facebook. And since they've not been named yet, I thought of a little Cat in the Hat trick. But baby A is 4 pounds, 3 ounces, and 17 inches long. And baby B is 4 pounds, 9 ounces, 17 and a half inches long. And mom is doing well. She says she's a little sore, but doing well. Imagine that. And so they are in a NICU still because of the being underweight. And so the prayer that Tisha asked us to have was for a continued weight gain. And so that they can get home, and just for her to heal up naturally as well. And so their life has really changed. They just don't even know how far and how much it's changed yet. And so they're still going to be in Denver for at least 2 weeks, probably, Sharon, or maybe even three, until the babies are released. And so if you are helping the family or said, I'm going to help them before the babies are come, well, it's a little late. But the opportunity to help is still there. So there's a lot of back and forth travel and probably the need for gift cards for food and things like that. If you're so inclined to do that, just talk with Sharon after the service. So, but what a joy and a blessing. Amen. So inside your weekly newsletter is a thank you from, it's in the orange section in there, of a thank you from the Genesis Food Bank Board for the donations that the church made towards their food, and then the money that we took up on Christmas Eve, as well as what was designated towards that throughout 2019. And so it's great to be in relationship and in partnership with Genesis to help those that are in need of food. So I invite you to read that as well. It's been a great week for our college, hasn't it? On Thursday was the dedication of the Big Blue Barn. Although can we still call it that? No? Okay. The Lampy Barn? Okay, all right. So, and then, of course, celebrating the anniversary yesterday. So, What a gift and a blessing to this community and to this area to have the college here and the life that it brings with all of the young people and the academics and the economic activity that a college brings to a community. So blessed to have that. Yesterday, Scott and Carolyn put on a lay servant ministry class to those interested in becoming lay servants within the church, and they had 7 people from the Hayes District come, and I think that's wonderful. And so thank you, Scott and Carolyn, for your leadership in that area, and for those that hear that calling from God that says, I'm not necessarily called to do what I do, and some days I'm not sure that I'm called to do what I do, but I want to do something more in my life to help others find Jesus in their life. And so thank you to both of you for your leadership in that. Also, I want to just say thank you to those who responded to our first use of the time, talent, and resource inventory list. We kind of put a call out to those who circled cleaning, since we're still without a custodian. Hopefully we can, I'll have you pray over that in just a second. But several of you stepped up and said, yeah, I'll come help. And so I so appreciate that. And thank you for a successful first attempt at using the gift surveys. And if you haven't filled them out yet, they're in your pews. And so please do so. We'll put you to work. That's the warning and the blessing. So on the concern side, we got word from Lee Bandy and from Bruce that Joe Creedy, am I saying that right? Creedy, thank you. Okay. She fell and had to have hip surgery this week, and she is still in the hospital in Topeka. And if you need their address, either get with Bruce or Lee or call the office on Tuesday, or anybody else. Sounds like others have their contact information if you want to send a get well card as well. And Larry's going to be making several trips to and from Denver over the next couple of weeks to deal with some health issues, particularly in his kidneys. And so, Larry, we're just going to be praying for you and for Cheryl as you come and go, and come what may from the doctors, and we just know you're in God's hands and in our prayers as well. So the other couple of things that I would just continue, and then also, down it goes. So Tracy wants prayers for Bob as he is doing some knee replacement surgery this week. Looks like Tuesday in Denver, and so definitely prayers for him and for you on a successful and complete recovery as well. So, yes. So a couple of the other things that I would just invite you to be in prayer about would be the position, the custodial position, as we're trying to get someone hired by the end of the month, and we've had several different applicants for that. And so just prayers for discernment and wisdom for having the right person come in. And then also just continued prayers for resolution for the basement at the parsonage. So that's a lot, isn't it? Sounds like we need God to take all that, right? So let's go to God, shall we? Gracious and loving God, we give you such thanks and joy for a successful entry into this world for the Carter twins. God, for Tisha and for Cade and for the two older brothers whose lives have just been turned upside down, even though they don't know it yet. And for these two little guys who have just entered into the world, we give you such thanks. May you just bless them in their growth and in their stay in the hospital, and watch over them, God, as the nurses and the doctors and all those that are in the NICU, help to get them home safely. And for all of the traveling back and forth for their family members as well, we just ask for mercies upon them. God, for our community college, as it's celebrating more than 50 years of service to this community and service to young adults and older adults and everyone in between, to continue to have that thirst for knowledge, the thirst for learning, the thirst for academic excellence and for athletic abilities in the classroom, outside the classroom, and in our community. God, we just thank you for all of the ways in which our lives are intertwined in this community and with the college. And so I give you thanks for the leadership that has got it to this point, for our current leadership and for the staff and the faculty as well. So I continue to cast out a vision for the college that integrates it and continues to intertwine it with this community and this region. We also lift up to you Larry and Joe as they're and Bob as they are undergoing medical treatments, and give thanks to all of those who hear the calling to healing, whether it is as a doctor or a nurse or CNA and other kinds of ways in which people get into and heal others physically. And may each and every one of us, God, be instilled with the spirit of spiritual healing, whether that's through the art of listening, the art of compassion, and using our gifts and the fruits of the Spirit to bring that about, so that no one journeys alone. God, in all things and in all ways, we wish to reflect you as closely as we can. And so, send out your Spirit upon us to be moved, to be shaken, to be stirred, so that we might better reflect you in our lives and in our relationships and our business transactions and in our neighborhoods and in our workplaces. And as Jesus taught those who followed him, so now we also join the prayer of the ages as we connect to disciples near and far, as we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
One life shaken, it makes all the difference in
Scripture reading this morning comes from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 9, verses 10 through 17. And as he sat at dinner in the house, many tax collectors and sinners came and were sitting with him and his disciples. When the Pharisees saw this, they said to his disciples, "Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?" But when he heard this, he said, "Those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick. Go and learn what this means. I desire mercy, not sacrifice, for I have come to call not the righteous, but sinners.